in Peachtree City, Georgia. Mike, you're still having fun with the house cleaning. I guess I'm just guessing that you're going to do another side today. It's a good thing you don't have one of them hexagonal houses. And work you to do.
Into the noise, but that's about 99%.
And, 43 degrees and 60 down here, which is a nice change.
I think it's actually going to get down to 58 before it turns around. And, we got the house open. Oh, it was good sleeping last night.
KK4GZQ. Good morning.
Oh, well, good morning, Kevin. Glad to hear you in here. I'll pass it to you here in just a moment. N4JK in the group, KN4AK. Okay, well, I know you didn't hear Jay. Jay is up in Dallas. He's on a photo shoot. He doesn't get home until tomorrow. He'll be on, tomorrow. He'll be on the air Friday. He's up there, and boy, he was giving me a report last night of the tornado damage. Yeah, he's been just tremendous. They've already determined it's going to be well over a $250 million damage estimate up there in the downtown area of Dallas. So his property that he's photographing is in good shape in the right part of town, but boy, he said there's some real devastation up there. Anyway, he's out. Charlie's been in the deep woods and doing other things and doing a little bit of work on it, so he hasn't been on. But they're both alive and well and doing good. So that's the deal. Why don't you, Perry, great signal. We heard you last night. You had a great signal last night coming through. So you would be gracious with your presence. Yeah, with a good signal. Glad to hear you. Boy, I'm struggling a little bit with you for some reason. We just don't have the best right now. I'm not sure what part of... Oh, I think you're in Coral Gables, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, for some reason, I'm having a little trouble. I'll try to bring you up on one of the SDR receivers and see how we do. At any rate, there you go. Joe, boy, that sounds great. maybe Judy should go away more often, and your kids will take pity on you and have you over for dinner more often.
Hey, I got to run down the hall, guys. I'll be back in a couple minutes. There'll be 3 MMR.
I'm working on the car.
Okay, thanks.
And be sure and get all that ham radio stuff off the block of tackles so you can make room for the car. Joe's the only shack I've ever been to, guys, that he has a block of tackle in the middle of his ham shack. I like that. I think that's great. That's just what you need to get that BC-610 around. That's a good deal. Okay, we'll keep it on going. Kevin, good morning to you. Glad to hear you. I was down the band this morning. There's a de-expedition over at Pitcairn Island. I got contact number 7 this morning. I've got them on a combination of the modes and the bands of 7, so I'm having fun with that. By the way, the South Pacific is coming in really well on 80. Okay, here she comes, Kevin. And if you would, turn it to Maury, N4DUI, please. KK4GSU, 27, KM4HH.
Okay, real good, Bob. KN4HH in the group, KK4GZQ, and Art, I heard Perry signing out, so I guess that's 73, Perry, if you're copying me up there. And good to hear you on this morning. I woke up late. This was one of those mornings when I jumped up out of bed and came in here and sat down and was ready to go this morning, and guess what time it was? I looked up. I'd already started the coffee in the kitchen, and it was 1:30 in the morning. Well, I went back to bed. Well, guess what? I overslept, so. Anyway, just getting in here, guys. Good morning to all of you, and it felt good to sleep in. And good morning to you, Bob. Hello to Maury, N4GUI, Joe, K4JCP, Art, N4JK, and... And also W3MMR that was signing out. I caught one right there at the tail end and heard him make one over with you guys. Well, Bob, I tell you, I knew that the damage was pretty good for our first reports, but just not exactly how bad. So I got a bird's eye view of it there, I guess. And sorry to hear that. And hopefully there was no lives lost. I guess the insurance companies would be busy down there trying to get things going again. So, anyway, not much here, guys. Just continuing to get ready. I had a good idea yesterday from Bruce KI4HHK, and he said he told me yesterday. He goes, "Well, I figured we'd figure with." All of the paintwork and pressure washing that you do, that you would have some extension poles around there. And I thought, well, no, I probably won't use one of those because it's got a saw on the end of it. But what am I going to use? Well, I got to looking at it yesterday. It was just one bolt and one nut. Slide it right out of there. It was easy as pie. So I've got my pole saw, less the blade, coming with me to Florida. And I think that's going to get me up off that deck at least. That thing's got to be, it's got to be 20 feet long, I guess. 18 feet anyway, Bob. So, anyway, I should have something for the center support coming off the deck there at St. George. And didn't have to go buy or make anything else from scratch. So, Maury, I haven't talked to you in a while. Good morning down to you. Let me send it your way and see what kind of copy I have on you there at down at Fort Myers, I think, somewhere down in there. Cape Coral, I think, Bob, is where he is, across the Caloosahatchee River from Fort Myers. N4GUI with the group. Good morning, Maury. KK4GZQ.
I'm 95%. control the vehicle. It goes in the positive direction, so that's not good. But,
I'm back, fellas. W3MMR.
I'm going to turn it over to Gerard. So, I'll get a few or 72 to go to. K4NCT. Good morning, Sam.
73 MMR back.
This is U4JK, and I got you, Perry. Yeah, Perry jumped in a minute ago, so you had to friend in Hall. Morning, before we are you using the tuning input, or are you just going straight to the grid?
I used to say Q, WB2HJK.
Grounded grid, grounded traffic, F1 turn.
Frequencies and use, George, stand by.
Do you have a tool circuit, or are you just using a technique tester for the input?
Put about 16 turns of
WB2HJK.
Wire on there.
Frequencies and use, George, stand by.
Talk about them. Up to you.
San Francisco.
W3MMR.
From N4JK.
N4JK in the group W3MMR. Well, good morning, Art. Pretty decent band conditions here this morning. A little bit of static, some static crashes, but nothing too bad. And utilizing the web SDR a little bit this morning, but kind of bouncing back and forth between the Anon receiver and the QIX web SDR up in Townsend, Massachusetts. Anyway, 55 degrees here this morning. We got a lot of rain yesterday. It was real misty and dreary most of the day. And then I guess around probably 2 o'clock in the afternoon, the skies just opened up and it poured and poured and poured. It seemed like until about, gosh, almost probably 9:30, 10 o'clock last night, until it slowed down a little bit. And then I guess from the all the rain, I'm sure you guys have heard me talk about some RFI, some interference issues I've been having. From all the rain, some power line noise rearing its ugly head that I've never heard before. It pretty much wipes out 160. It's not too bad here on 75 for some reason. But like I said, it wipes out 160, wipes out the broadcast band, kind of skips over 75 meters, and wipes out 40 meters. Luckily, in my Anon, some of the filters, the noise blanker on this rig, knocks it out 100% when it's in there. But the way this noise blanker works in the Anon, if there's a strong signal in the pass band of the radio, I'm not sure exactly, you know, in between what width. But if there's a strong enough signal that goes over a certain threshold, it breaks the noise blanker. So if there's a strong sideband signal in there, every time he modulates, the noise blanker goes off. So it's like the noise floor is bouncing up and down, you know, 10 or 20 dB. But nevertheless, it seems to work okay. It definitely does knock it out. So I went out last night and was able to track down what pole it was at and wrote down the pole. So I got to call the power company today and see if I can get them to come out and take care of it. So that's all I got to do on my day off today. So anyway, keep things moving around here. Good morning, Kevin. Heard you jump in there. I guess I turn it over to you. I'm not sure. If not, I apologize, and whoever is supposed to get it, pick it up, and I'll hopefully get things in order the next show around. KK4GZQ in the group W3MMR.
WB2HJK. Good morning.
Okay, and Art, I saw something on the pan adapter there. I'm wondering if you copied the banking station. W3MMR, it goes over to N4JK from KK4GZQ. Good morning, Perry.
That was WB2HJK, George in Queens.
Do I have it?
Hold on, George.
Let's see here. George, take it, Perry, and then probably send it down to Art, N4JK there, over.
All right, go ahead, George, and then send it down to Art, N4JK. WB2HJK in the group, W3MMR.
Thank you, Perry. Good morning. And, Jerry, why don't you go ahead and take it, because I'm not too sure if even this propagation time would be good for me. So, Jerry, go ahead and take it. My call is Whiskey Baker 2, Hotel Japan Kilo. Extend my best wishes to all on frequency, WB2HJK. Good morning, all.
Go ahead, Art. Pick it up. N4JK, W3MMR.
W3MMR from N4JK.
Well, good morning to you there, George.
I'm listening on the WA1 QIX SDR.
ER and treat the good old lab. Not so good direct. And that area that you have the source of your line noise identified. I'm using a SDR here as well. And man, down from the soft water and the air and all that, voice is a real problem. The voice blankers on these rigs sure look like those pop. I really appreciate it. So this is a flex top out. One mic on it's real good. And glad you got the day off today. I hope you spent a lot of time playing with the ham radio. Real good on all the rain. We had it the day before. Cleared up yesterday. It's a beautiful day now. It's 60 degrees here right now. Let's see, I think it needs to get over to Joe. K4JCP is the group. Or N4JK. Sounds like Joe is getting some coffee. Bob, you go ahead.
N4JK. Okay, we'll give Joe a minute to get squared away there. N4JK in the group can. Alright, good morning to George. Not hearing you too well, George. I had some headcast to use to get on one of the remote receivers. I couldn't hear you in that this morning. And, Perry, that's interesting about the noise blacker. We, you know, that's one thing I really like about these flex radios. They have what's called a wideband noise blanker in them, which is really good for impulse noise across the band. It's really pretty effective. It works out pretty well. It does seem to have the that kind of pumping action that some of the earlier aeroband noise blankers had. They need to figure out the algorithm to make that work pretty well. So at any rate, hope you get that noise track down. Isn't that annoying? Particularly just when there's somebody you want to work and all of a sudden noise comes on. Alright, Moore, I heard you real good that time. Your T150 and that amplifier is doing a really good job. I think you said you're running 150 watts of a Fed State carrier. Hearing you just do very, very fine this morning. And Kevin, boy, countdown. That's great. I'm sure glad. I knew you'd come through with something, Kevin, that'll work. But we're sure counting on hearing you down there. Or so. I'm not sure Friday or Saturday, but I sure am looking forward to hearing from you down there. Sure, we're sure a little bit closer, but we'll stay in touch. If nothing else, I'll throw you a text or so if I don't hear from you. But we'll see what's going on. So, there you have it, guys. I'm going to go ahead and sign. I want my coffee, too, before it's time for the 72 or 3 session. So, I'm going to go ahead and say 70 degrees. I'm going to try Joe again, hopefully. He's back with coffee in hand. If not, Art, I'll let you redirect. 73s, everybody. Y'all have a great day. K4JCP. Good morning, all. KN4HH.
Two to one.
Joe. K4JCP in the group, KK4G's at 732. I think that signed out, I guess. Good morning again, Bob. Great to hear you, and wish you could make the trip down with everyone and meet up down at St. George. And I think BJ is going to he mentioned maybe trying, but you know what? Seems like he made a retraction here maybe a week or so ago that he didn't think he was going to be able to make it. Art, I've got K4EDZ's call here. I'm going to Jimmy Alford. I think you said he went by Alford over at Port St. Joe. I'm going to try to drop him an email and let him know that you and Joe and maybe John. I'd like to see John and meet John and have him along with the group. We'll make a little. We'll make a trek of it, guys. I've got some stuff that I can show you over there, and I think you'd be interested in, and we'll have a good time together. That's for sure. Won't be any problem with that whatsoever. Good morning to Perry. W3MMR, good signal coming out of near Philadelphia. And again, good morning to I think it was it Frank maybe over in Queens. No, it was George, WB2HJK there, and I had a good copy on George right above S9 here. So great to hear you in there this morning, George. And Art, if I can get fiberglass pole that I've got there. I'm planning on putting it on off the deck on the back, and I think I've got enough room on each side of the property to be able to stretch this thing broadside north-south instead of the last time. I kind of had it east-west, and it was kind of cocked around one leg of it just however I could get it. So going a little better prepared, I should be able to get the antenna out in the open air a little better and should be able to produce a little better signal as long as ground conditions are, you know, good that week like we had before there years back. So Perry, this will be the second time that I've actually set up on the location here at the Burbs Nest there at St. George Island. Anyway, I don't want to just keep it here and hog it and dog it here. So, Art, does it go back to Perry from here? N4JK in the group, KK4GZQ.
Does it come to me, Kevin? I'm sorry, I lost Art there. He took a fade.
He did on me as well, Perry. And there's a breaking station, Tango Papa there, Art. N4JK to direct it, KK4GZQ.
N4JK in the group, W3MMR, and hello to the breaking station. Just when I get done here and try to break in again there, maybe we'll be able to catch your call this time, but unfortunately I was not able to get it. But my call is Whiskey 3 Mike Mike Romeo. The name is Perry Papa Echo Romeo Romeo Yankee in Chester, Pennsylvania, 7 miles southwest of the big city of brotherly love, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. But anyway, good, Kevin, on this is being the second time that you're going to be setting up a station down there at that beautiful Burbs Nest. That's a cool name, the Burbs Nest. It's definitely not in the suburbs, though, I'll tell you that. It's definitely out there, it looks like. I guess you said, on the Forgotten Coast. But boy, oh boy, does that place look beautiful. I would love to be able to, I don't know if I would love to live in a place like that, you know, a year round. But I'm sure it would be nice year round, but, you know, I guess the house is on stilts, you know, dealing with flooding and the hurricanes that, you know, that come through of Florida and things like that. And, But a good thing is it's got plenty of trees to put antennas in. I remember you saying something about utilizing the back deck for your antenna for the wire there. So maybe you can speak on that next time it comes to you, or what your plans might be for hanging a piece of wire. And I'm really looking forward to being able to work you from down there, Kevin. Especially now that my noise level's been lower here at the house, and hopefully, you know, copy you direct and not via the web SDR, which will be real fun. One of the good things about things I love about this great hobby that we're all obsessed with. But anyway, it's still 55 degrees here. I think it's supposed to be really nice today. Birds are chirping. No clouds out in the sky at the moment. And don't have much to do here on my day off. Just got to call the power company and see if I can schedule for them to come out and look at that pole down the street. And that's about it. But 73 to you, Bob, KN4HH. Bob, you were the channel master this morning. Real, real big signal if you're still listening. So two thumbs up on that. That sounded really good this morning. At the QTH and on the web SDR. 73 to Mari. I'm sure he's gone by now. But anyway, keep things moving along here. So I guess the breaking station, if you want to go ahead and try to break in again there. And if not, I kind of guess it comes over to you, Joe, K4JCP. This is W3MMR.
You talking about me?
Okay, W3MMR. Good morning, Terry. The call here is W3PAPA, Victor Echo 3PP, and my name is Rick Romeo India, Charlie Kilo here in Southern Ohio. Hopefully, some of you can stop at me. Just wanted to get in and say good morning. Some nice signals here. Kevin, you were good. Terry, you got a pretty good signal up here, too. And there was a few others there that I could copy fairly well up here this morning, too. Won't keep it. I'll just pass it along to the next guy. Just wanted to get in and say good morning, gentlemen, from Southern Ontario, VE3PP.
Good morning, Rick.
Send it over to the next guy, okay?
Joe's got it.
Direct. I had the SDR on up in Mass there, and listening to Jerry. And it's this armchair up there. It's a little bit high on me down in the football season.
Frequencies in use.
The frequency is in use.
Good morning to you there, Rick. Like Joe, I'm picking up on the Joe, and Fort Walton Beach.
10-4JK with the group with Victor Echo 3 Papa Papa. Good morning, Rick. KK4GZQ, Kevin near Lexington with the sun starting to peek out here over the eastern sky. It looks beautiful over the gorge this morning.
It's cool out there. I didn't give you a temperature report, but it's
chilly down here. Feels kind of good. I kind of like it. And aren't you and Roy were talking about the 813s. I was pretty intrigued, and it's a subject matter that I'm trying to learn more about.
Amplifiers, transmitters,
I think that's something that I could troubleshoot or work on or maybe even build at some point in my time here, hopefully. And you guys were talking about grounded grid, and I've been looking into this more and more, talking about grounding grid and whether it's cathode-driven or screen-driven. Starting to learn, the breakdown of the tube and how it exactly works and then how you get it in operation and tunable with you talked also about a tuned input on it. All that stuff just really intrigues me a lot. But, that 813 amp that I've got back here, Art, in the big cabinet, the one that Tim, KV4BK, worked on for me, he did some nice work on the thing. It's got tuned input switchable on both 40 and 80, or 75 and 40, rather. And makes it really nice, and it loads up and works really well. Anyway, Joe, I haven't said much to you. Looking forward to seeing you in Art. And, we're going to try to use one of the off the back deck since it's already got some height.
Perry mentioned the house being up on stilts.
And I'll come off that back deck up in that corner, I believe, and I'll bungee the... I'll affix that fiberglass pole whatever way I see fit there to maybe the corner post there. And come off that, I've got a non-metallic center post for my antenna, which I think was it actually makes sense to do. This antenna that you guys are listening to me now is on a mast that's affixed in a hazer on a tower, and the mast is made out of a Schedule 40 PVC. And I need to get in there and I want to change it out. And I want to put Schedule 80 in there. The 40 kind of, we had an ice storm down here and it's kind of bent over now. Anyway, I won't get too long-winded here about everything, but good morning all the way around. Let's see, Joe Hunt, Art, Perry, let's see, who did I send it to the last time? I know Bob has signed, N4GUI has signed. Perry, I'm going to go ahead and turn it to you. And maybe you can get Rick back in, and I don't know if George was with it or not. So, W3MMR, I'll stay for one more. KK4GZQ in the group.
Yeah, KK4GZQ in the group, W3MMR. this will be my last transmission here, and I'll listen out. I'm going to start... I think I'm going to move down the band, or move up the band, see what's going on 40, and maybe hop up to 20 a little bit later in the morning and see what conditions are like. I believe that I haven't checked the solar forecast today, but I believe, that's a good thing about these Anons. You can pull up the... a gray line map on the back, on the pan adapter, and it also brings you can also bring up information on the solar flux, numbers, and the A index. For some reason, it's not popping up right now. Oh boy. Anyway, good general update about the antenna, Kevin. And the deck, are you already having some height with the deck there, so that should work out real well. And I think my next project is going to be a balanced antenna tuner. I'd like to build the Rick Measures quote unquote balanced tuner with two two roller inductors and a capacitor, and a pretty simple setup, but seems to work very well. A lot of guys use them. I'm using a Tentec 238 at the moment for my antenna tuner. Well, before that, I was using an MFJ 989, the VersaTuner 5, the older version. But the roller inductor, would heat up. Would heat up here on AM, especially with longer transmissions. And I knew I was getting some loss with that. And a friend, a local here, was selling this Tentec, which is in pristine condition. It's an older tuner, but works great. And he was selling it for a really good price, so I jumped on it. But the one good thing about that MFJ tuner, I think it'll tune anything. It's got a real wide tuning range with a T-network in it. So you can tune just about anything. I could tune this doublet, this 125-foot doublet on 160 meters. So you can tune it flat, which I cannot do with this 238. But I did buy an AirCore roller inductor for the 989, the MFJ tuner, the updated AirCore roller inductor for that. So maybe we'll get that in one of these days, and just keeping that tuner as a backup. But anyway, good morning to you, Rick. Big signal in Chester, Pennsylvania this morning. About 15 over here at the QTH, copying you direct very well. Great to hear you this morning, coming out of the cold country, out of southern Ontario this morning. So anyway, 7-3, everybody. It's always a pleasure to talk to you fellas in the morning. It really gets my day started. I'm on the right foot. Being able to jump in here with you guys in the morning, and Art and Bob and Mari this morning, and Kevin and you, Joe, K4JCP. You guys make my mornings that much better here. So 7-3, everyone. We'll turn it over to you, Rick VE3PP, and then I believe it goes to Joe from there. So 7-3, everyone. Take care. Have a blessed day, and we'll hopefully talk to you fellas again tomorrow morning. 7-3 VE3PP in the group. This is W3MMR.
Yeah, okay, Barry. Well, have a good day there. And I'm actually in St. Thomas. I'm south of London here, a little bit, so not that far from the north shore of the lake here. I don't know, maybe 9 miles in patrol flies, and straight across from the glorious city of Cleveland, Ohio. And okay, on your tuner there, I got a Palstar here, an AT1500 that I've had quite a while, and it's half a good tuner. It works for me. I don't use it a lot, but I got it in line here now because the antenna is a little lower in the band, so I put the tuner in line when I'm up here. Anyways, it looks like it's going to be a decent day up here, up into the 50s. Going to take the drive down to the golf course here and put it on the peg and keep playing here as long as I can. The weather, the wind is going to be long and cold up here. And sitting around all the time is gets boring. So try to play as much golf as I can here late in the fall. Kevin, good morning to you. I know you're a couple of days away from your vacation trip, so hopefully I can hear you from down south there one of the mornings. And that's about it. I'll make this my last transmission. I got to get up and get some breakfast here and jump in the shower here and get ready to go. I got a 9:30 tea time. It's going to be a little nippy, I think, still on the first tee at 9:30. But
hey, Perry.
Maybe once the sun comes up here, it'll warm up a few degrees. But, hey, we're Canadian, we're tough up here. 73, gentlemen. Everybody,
are you there?
And I'll look for you all again in the future. Joe, I don't have your call, so if you can copy me, I'll just turn it over to you, because I couldn't copy you that well up here. 73, all V3PP.
Rick, Victor Echo 3. You're at Kilmore JCC. Kilo 4, Polo. Kilo 4, Julian. Looking at your QRZ shot there. Good looking Mustang.
Cart.
M4GK in the group.
KK4GZQ.
Go ahead and make this one a final.
And it's been fun, even though we got in here late this morning. A nice group in here. And Rick, great to hear you coming from Ontario this morning. Good signal.
Good signal from Perry, Joe, Art.
Maury was good and strong.
Herb was good and strong.
And even heard George, WB2HJK there in Queens with a good, decent signal out of New York. So nice to hear the band come around. You know, I don't want to count my chickens before they hatch, but the last time I was at that property, I had the antenna, the best I can figure, it was broadside, probably kind of east, northeast to, you know, west, southwest. Something like that, and I think this time, if I can get it laid on the property the other way, broadside north-south, that'll help me to get back, you know, up toward Kentucky here, and into Michigan, and into Pennsylvania, and so on, but I did notice the antenna worked well going west. I think you guys remember me making the comment that while I've been over in the panhandle, that Texas signals seem to really come in especially strong over in the panhandle. Noticed a lot of fives out there really coming in strong. So anyway, that's just something. Maybe the band conditions were right at that time for that. But I don't, like I said, don't want to count my chickens before they hatch. But you know, last time I was there with 25 watt carrier, it worked. Bill out Washtenaw out in Washington or what have you. I worked Jay, KK5IM, and worked Dan, KD4UMU up here, and maybe Jerry, K9GAS. I think I worked Borgie, K9YQQ there in Indianapolis. So hoping to get some good band conditions and hopefully get the antenna up where it has a good chance of being efficient. So with that, I'm not sure who has signed and who has it, Art. Let me send it back to you. And Art, yeah, the 813s, I went ahead and grabbed about four of them while I was in Dayton this past year. I don't know if I'll end up pulling that RF deck out of that big cabinet and the power supply, because that cabinet could be really used for something pretty special. And the amplifier that's inside of it it may take up half of the room in it. So it's basically a big hollow cabinet with a little bit of radio gear in it. But it looks pretty impressive, that's for sure. And, just trying to learn, Art, more about, you know, grid-driven, cathode-driven, screen-driven. You know, I'm still trying to get all that straight in my head and just how it all comes together. And maybe one day when the light bulb goes off and I feel comfortable with it, we might try a few things ourselves here. So, Art, back to you, Bus 73, everybody. It's been a great morning with you and a pleasure and a privilege. N4JK to take it and send it where it goes, Art. KK4GZQ. Okay, Joe, my friend. Joe, I haven't heard one word, not one peep out of him. I need to probably just pick up the phone and check on him. Don, Whiskey Charlie 4 Delta over here in Lexington, it looked like he was going to get on the air here for a while, and then I haven't heard much out of him. So maybe we need to make a call to Don and Tim both and see if they're okay and see if they want to do a little AM here.
Okay, I understand.